In this video, we will be looking at exothermic and endothermic reactions. During chemical reactions, thermal energy can be transferred to and taken in from the surroundings. In an exothermic reaction, energy is released into the surroundings, causing the temperature of the surroundings to increase. Examples of exothermic reactions include combustion and neutralization. In endothermic reactions, energy is taken in from the surroundings, so the temperature of the surroundings decreases. Examples of these types of reaction include thermal decomposition. You can therefore identify whether a reaction is exothermic or endothermic by taking the initial and final temperatures of a reaction mixture and observing whether the temperature increases or decreases. A good way of remembering which way around these reactions work is using exo equals exits to help you, indicating that energy exits the reaction mixture. Reaction pathway diagrams can be used to show the relative energies of the reactants and the products. In an exothermic reaction, energy is given out to the surroundings, so the energy of the product will be lower than that of the reactant. The increase in energy represents the activation energy, which is the minimum energy needed for the reaction to start, and the difference in energy between the reactants and products is the overall energy change. The direction of the arrow goes down, showing that energy has been released. For an endothermic reaction, energy is taken in from the surroundings, so the product will have more energy than the reactant. Again, the initial rise in energy represents the activation energy, and the difference between the energy of the products and the reactants is the overall energy change. As we can see here, this time the arrow points upwards, showing that energy has been absorbed. You can sometimes see reaction pathway diagrams, referred to as energy level diagrams. Let's look at some exam questions on this topic. A student investigates the temperature change when hydrochloric acid is added to sodium hydroxide. They measure the initial and final temperature, the results of which are shown in the table. You are asked to explain whether the reaction is exothermic or endothermic. Notice that the question is only one mark, which means you must state the type of reaction and give a reason for your answer. We have said that the temperature of the surroundings increases in an exothermic reaction and decreases in an endothermic reaction. Looking at these results, we can see that in each experiment, the temperature increases. The reaction is therefore exothermic because the temperature increases. This question shows you a simplified energy level diagram and asks you to explain how the diagram shows that the reaction is exothermic. To do this, we must compare the energy of the reactants and the products. As we can see, the energy of the products is lower than that of the reactants, and this explains why it is exothermic, because in an exothermic reaction, energy is given out to the surroundings, so the product will have less energy than what you started with. This answer will score you one mark. You could also have said that the energy of the reactants is higher than the products. To summarise, an exothermic reaction gives out energy to the surroundings, causing the temperature of the surroundings to increase. Endothermic reactions take in energy from the surroundings, causing the temperature of the surroundings to decrease. Reaction pathway diagrams show the relative energies of the reactants and products and allows you to identify whether a reaction is exothermic or endothermic. The reaction pathway diagram for an exothermic reaction shows the energy of the products lower than the reactants, and for an endothermic reaction shows the energy of the products higher than the reactants. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.